Welcome back to the Engi B run. We find ourselves in Sector 5, a little bit apprehensive about the future. We have an alright weapons loadout for now, 5 power, decent ions, and an okay punchy weapon. But we're starting to get some hints that enemies are starting to pick back up in their shields and engines level and their defenses and whatnot. And I'm not entirely sure whether this is going to be good enough to deal with more powerful enemy ships as this sector progresses, but we're going to have to just wait and see on that. Our corresponding defenses are alright, but they could still certainly use some improvement. We don't have any particularly good answer to enemy missiles at the moment. And we just took a little bit of a risk as far as buying this halberd beam, when we're not necessarily going to get immediate use out of it. Eventually it'll be nice when we have 7 weapons power, but that day may be far in the future. So we're just gonna have to wait and see. As was suggested in some earlier fights, it would be really nice if we could add hacking to this loadout to guarantee that a very large amount of our ion lands. We could charge this all the way up to full and then guarantee 5 damage to enemy shields by hacking piloting or engines, which would be really nice. So that's certainly one option for further developing our offense. This fight doesn't look too bad. Obviously, they're armed to the teeth, but we should be able to knock out their offense fairly easily. Let's see, is that closer? Which one of these is better? Probably the heavy ion, honestly, because it's already charged up, and it'll take about 6 seconds to charge it up to full. And I want to ensure that one of the heavier weapons gets taken out, like, for example, that one. Alright, so we got a little bit hurt there, but nothing too bad. Alright, let's hold our fire. They're about to close, like so. Okay, so we took some damage, and that was a kind of a nasty weapons loadout, so we kind of expect to, but we're okay. We're fine. Took a little bit of a slice in there, but, you know, if they don't have very good defenses, we're certainly well set up to do damage to ships that don't have shields, that's for sure. And if they do have shields, we'll make them not have shields. Yeah, probably everything on engines. Just the thought was nice. My heart was in the right place, but yeah, with that, now we've got a better chance of landing that, which means we've got a better chance of landing this stuff. I guess we can hit cloaking now, probably. See if they got, I was gonna say see if they add level 2 cloaking, but, I guess we'll see. It's a long cloak, it's probably level 3, I think. I think I can sneak in one more shot at the engines before I hit weapons again. They are pretty well taken out. I think they would put this ion blast online before the halberd beam. Although it doesn't really matter. They are blown to smithereens. Okay. So we took a bit of damage there, but nothing really to be that worried about. That was pretty average as far as that fight was expected to go, I think. And that was because they hit us on the weapons. If they hit us anywhere else on the ship, that fight would have been over even faster. Alright, so now where to? We've got... does that connect? Yes, it does. So we're probably best off spending some time in this nebula section and then going up and then around. This is a little bit awkward, though. So maybe we want to end up down here. Like, spend some time up here, then go down here, and then over here. Get here at the exact right time. I think that's going to work best for most flexibility, because that way we spend most of the time over here, to the right of the approaching wave front. Then we can jump here with perfect timing, whereas here our timing might be awkward with respect to how this thing advances discreetly. So we're going to go up, and then down, and then up. Oh, look at me not healing my crew again. Oh well. Okay, here is the infamous Defense Drone 2 that I was a little bit worried about. We may not actually be able to hurt this ship. We'll see. I'll give it a try, but don't be too surprised if I decide to run away from this one. It's gonna be a little bit hard getting through, I think. Particularly because we only have the one shot. Like, our heavy laser is a physical projectile. If we had a beam, we might be in slightly better shape. Guess I might as well fire this too, just in case. Oh, and they stun-bombed us in the shields. Cute. Real cute. I need to charge this charge ion all the way up to full, otherwise we're not going to be able to make it through. On the plus side, at least, we have plenty of dodge too, so they don't exactly have the easiest time getting through, and this basic laser is the only thing that even does damage. So they're not going to hurt us for very much, even if they do manage to get through us. But it's still not all that, exciting. Hopefully this blows up. That would be nice. Nope. Well, it was worth a shot. I was gonna say that because I would run them lower on drone parts. Not that I hope that that's ever gonna happen, but, we'll see. I think it's worth sticking around at least. They don't seem to be able to get through us particularly easy. Okay, that's actually good. I mean, if I'd known that ahead of time, I should have shot drones, but, I definitely shouldn't just shoot that now. But I might be able to sneak one more shot through now. Because if I can just land one heavy laser shot to the drones. Okay, good. Now we're in good shape. Yeah, now we should kill them, no problem. If we could just keep the pressure up on them. Alright, hopefully they shot the heavy laser. Alright, we're back to square one. But, it was worth a shot. Yeah, so I should probably just should not have auto-fire on this battle, period. Alright, if it's any consolation, eventually they'll run out of stun bombs and we'll be a little bit safer. Or they could make it through our shields, that could happen too. Alright, I'm gonna fire the heavy laser first, so hopefully they shoot down the heavy laser and more of my ions land. Like so. Alright, probably worth sticking this out. I might get hit by one heavy, like, one regular laser, but, that would be okay. Probably want them to turn off the heavy ion, probably. Or I could miss, that's cool too. I would be okay with that. Or, you know, that could miss too. Ah, jeez. I guess my timing is just off or something. I would expect them to shoot the first thing, but I guess it's just prioritizing the laser too much. Like, I did sneak one shot in. It does work. But, I ionized it. Brilliant. Glorious. Maybe I can get them to shoot. Might still be able... If I still have enough time left to shoot one more heavy laser in. There we go. Yeah, so I think I just have to wait until it actually, like, starts swiveling towards the ion projectile and then fire the heavy laser when it's on cooldown. That might be the way to do it. Because if they arrive too quickly, it might just have the choice. Thankfully, their shields seem to be staying down. I'm just going to shoot the drones again. I'm just going to trust that their engines are low. Yeah, I think that's going to be better overall. Just keep that thing down. I seem to be landing enough. All I say is that goes up again. Yeah, there we go. How much damage are we willing to take in order to finish this fight? I'd say, like, two. We're getting really lucky on these kinds of dodges, though. That was pathetic. Okay. Well, we might make it through eventually, I think. It's going to be really slow. I mean, I was hoping to land a few more critical heavy laser shots to keep him busy, but, you know, if we don't land particularly many, they are just going to keep regenerating faster than we can really effectively do anything about anything. Still, though, we might stand a decent chance here. I say as they take our shields down again. Yeah, I wasn't quite expecting to dodge that one. Not with an ionized piling system. Good. Get that back online, sure. I think they might be out of stun bombs now. Yeah, they're out of stun bombs. Okay, now we should be able to get this third shot in easily. Alright, I definitely credit the charge ion for making this work. I think if we had any other ion, like, say, double heavy ion, or like, ion blast 2 and heavy ion, there's no way this would have worked. We would not have been able to kill these guys at all. And I am auto-firing my ions like I'm not supposed to be again. Let's hope I can get this extra shot in. Jeez. Alright, guess we're gonna have to do this whole thing one more time. We will get there. They are barely hurting us. I think we only took, like, 3 or 4 damage in this whole fight, but we certainly could have taken a lot more, but that's still not something you want to hear from somebody who only has a basic laser. Yeah, certainly level 5 engines would be doing us a favor with a fight of this long. That certainly would have done something. Sheesh, I'm still rolling my eyes at this, though. This is brutal. This is exactly why ion loadouts aren't really that good. Like, you really need special circumstances to make them work. At the very least, these defense 2s are pretty rare, though. That is one consolation I could take from all this. I'm still gonna take that damage, though. Or I could dodge it. That's cool, too. Try not to lean too heavily into this, but... okay, this might work, too. Maybe that'll blow up. Maybe that'll blow up. Okay, can this be over? Now it can be over. 42 scrap, though. Definitely worth sitting that one through, though. If we jumped away, we wouldn't have gotten any of that. So, definitely glad I toughed that one out. Alright, so what's next for our intrepid crew? So like I said, we can just buy more weapons. And just have a goal of, like, spending more money and get the halberd being online, which would be amazing. Or we could be more modest and incremental and try and get our defenses up. But I think we're hitting the point of diminishing returns on these. I think I would rather just have the buffer power for this, at least. Just the buffer bar. Okay, so like I said, 6 gives us some options. We could just run like this, 5 weapons power with a buffer. Or we could do this. So what is the attractive, why would we want to do this instead of the other one? So what would this look like against 3 shields? We charge the charge ion up to full. We get probably 1 shield down. We would be very lucky if that took 2 shields down. So probably 1 shield. Then the heavy laser might or might not take down 1 shield. So we can only really consistently get 2 shields down with this. We will hit them with the halberd beam. And that can be guaranteed damage even against the 3 shield ship. So you can pierce through that, hit like 4, like 3 or 4 systems with this, all for 1 damage. That can be really handy. This never misses. And if we're lucky enough to stack up the ion or get like even more shields down, then this does full damage. The problem is if it's like the heavy laser misses or something. We're fairly well certain of getting 2 shields down at least though. This might be worth a try. This might actually be better than what we were
were doing before.
I don't know. What we were doing before worked pretty well, though, for the most part. Like, it was just against that one ship that was bad. But a three-shield ship without anything special, without a defense drone 2, without cloaking, can get pieced up pretty badly by those ions. And we're not likely to run into either of them in this sector. Like, that's probably the last NG ship we'll see. So I think we're going to just go back to this. I think I'm just going to tough it out and stay with this. With 90 scrap, just 90 scrap, then I won't have to make that decision anymore. But I think for now this is bad. We'll see. I still reserve the right to change my mind later. Alright, nothing. Yeah, there's no reason to lose heart yet. Okay, they are not being held hostage, but they gave us free money at least. And some cookies. Yeah, maybe these cookies will get her morale up. Okay, we've got cloaking. And a big missile, but thankfully no shields. I think we can pretty much ignore the Ion Blast 2 and the bomb. Those should pretty much take care of themselves. Guess you can get shields for whatever that's worth. It's worth exactly nothing. Alright, get back into oxygen, I guess, so you can be on hand or a pair of weapons. And we don't care about any of these other weapons. We want to keep our heavy laser online and just hammer away at their weapons. Hopefully we only get hit by one of these. Alright, we got hit by one of them. Tell you what, yeah, you go ahead and go down there and help. You go down there and help, too. In fact, you're gonna ride first, so you stay on weapons. They ion my shields. You jerks. Not that that actually matters, but still, you jerks. Like, you could ion my weapons now, actually. Actually, my ions are doing great against them. Yeah, good work, ions. You actually saved us. The heavy laser didn't really do much there, but ioning the weapon system, perfectly legitimate tactic for getting that missile offline there. Man, that's a long cloak. No wonder they got that missile off. Okay, it's breached. Both of those are down now. They're not ionized at all right now. So I guess we're going to switch over to engines and try and finish them off ASAP. Yeah, they should be no harm to anybody now. I did shoot at the engines, not the cloaking, right? I did shoot at that, not this. I'll have to double check the footage. I could have sworn I was aiming at engines with that heavy laser shot. Alright, well, that was weird. So you can see we're going to get up to that 90 scrap pretty soon, just because the scrap awards in this late in the game are pretty good. So we'll see who's laughing when I have the power of the halberd beam on my side. Then we're talking. Then we're going to be doing some business. We're going to be giving people the business, because we are the business. Okay. Do we want to risk the Great Eye? This could kill one of our crew. On the other hand, it could. Most of the time, it will give us great rewards. Most of the time. You know what? We're doing things casually around here well enough. I think we can keep the ship running with only three crew. I'm gonna risk it. Ryan just died. Why wasn't anybody around here to tell me not to do it? If only somebody had warned me about the dangers of the Great Eye, then I wouldn't have done it. But, you know, I guess we don't deserve to have four crew. That's a shame, that is. Alright, moving right along. Alright, they are in our doors. Thankfully, we still have level 2 doors, so we still have doors. And, they should not be in particularly good shape against us. I could deploy an anti-personnel drone, but there's no reason to, so I just won't. And they should choke out pretty darn well before they get anywhere near any of our important systems. Yeah, you're not looking too hot, buddy. Yeah, those boarders could have used some more training. They couldn't even beat up 3 Engi. Jeez. Well, I guess if they didn't have any sensors, they wouldn't know where to teleport onto, but, you know, some space marines they are. Let's see, I guess we've got time to spend. We might as well spend it. So I guess we'll jump around in this nebula and then to the distress, and then see from there how many of these beacons we want. But both of these ought to be okay. They aren't going to be good, the great eye, probably. Okay. This is actually something I didn't consider. We don't have a lot of power for a plasma storm. We need a lot of power to keep all these weapons running. We certainly want all of them at the same time. Whoever we run into is likely to have 2 shields, maybe even 3. Probably only 2, though, probably because of the plasma storm. But still, 2 shields we're not doing all that well against. Like, the charge ion is sort of helpful, but not really. So it's really a question of, do we think 2 shields is going to be good enough against whatever they're going to have powered the ion storm? I kind of think not. We're likely to take a lot of damage, I think. I would prefer to just stay at 12 hull rather than take like 6 damage and win this fight, is what I'm thinking. So I think I'm just going to ignore this fight. We're not particularly well set up for it. If I had a backup battery, I'd probably try it, but I think we're just not equipped for this. Probably just going to leave it alone, and that probably is for the better. On the other hand, we could run into somebody like this, who's just a jerk who has cloaking and a missile. Would be a good time to have a defense drone, but, you know, that's just not where we're at this point of the game. I mean, we have a border, but that's kind of beside the point, really. Do I want to vent oxygen? Probably not when I'm at this low. I'll vent through doors instead. I mean, he's going to go into oxygen anyway, so I guess I'll vent oxygen instead. And that is going to be a breach missile. No, it is a Hermes again. Okay, well, maybe we can keep them from firing another one. Maybe. You know, it was a nice thought. We maybe could have prevented that. I think we're just going to jump away from this. There is no reason to stick around for something this awful. This is not a matchup we are well geared towards winning. I'm just going to let that through, because I want to go to the next fight with actual shields. Now, one thing I will do is see if I can dodge this. Okay, I can't, but we weren't ready to jump away anyway, so... Alright, so looks like I took 6 damage and did win a fight. That's no good. And Dido is dying because I left him with no air. Okay. Sure. Fine. You need to go to receive medical treatment right away. Is there a fire? I thought there was a fire. There might have been a fire. Maybe there isn't a fire. There is not a fire. But there could have been a fire. There just wasn't a fire. Okay. Well, we'll make this work. Soon enough, we shall be more powerful than anybody could possibly imagine, but we're just not quite there yet. Nothing, and do we want to go to a store? Probably. Do we have anything to sell? Yeah, we've got the explosive replicator, and the heavy laser, actually. And the anti-personnel drone, honestly. So, yeah, let's do it. Let us solidify ourselves. And there's our defense 1. A little late, but it is there. There's hacking, also attractive. We're certainly not keeping that. So that's a thing that's happening. I think it's also fair to say we are selling the heavy laser and installing the halberd beam. And we will... Do we buy the weapon control immediately? Probably not. That is something really important to note, is that even though we can buy this immediately, we don't have to. We could spend some more money and end up like down at like 70 or 80 scrap and still be fine. Or no, we couldn't. No, actually, we really couldn't. Okay, fine. So I think we're going to go with that, and then we're going to fix our ship and call it good, because we've got plenty of fuel, and we don't want anything else in the store now. So that'll be that. That's good enough, though. Alright, now we're going to be a force to be reckoned with, though. Now we're going to do amazing damage. Because the Heavy Laser 1 is fast, and it does cause fires and breaches, and it does do 2 damage to one system. But this can do 2 damage to many systems, and it can do 1 damage through 1 shield. It's pretty good. Also, the Rebels are going to overtake this beacon, because I miscounted. I thought I was going to be able to get here in time. Okay, well, what do we do about that? We're probably just going to turn off our weapons and try and turn on our engines, but it's probably really too late to do anything about it. I think the repairs are still the best we can do. So can we jump here in 3 jumps? That's actually the real question. Well, we'll find out here. It doesn't matter which of these we go to, but we'll reassess when we're done here. It's too late to do anything about this, but at least we can just, see what we can do here. Okay, here's the Zoltan police I was worried about. So we've got some intruders on board. They are in piloting. So here's how you deal with intruders in piloting. You vent piloting to make them go into the med bay. There are 3 of them. I want that to vent faster, so I'm gonna use all my airlocks. You're gonna need to help too, in fact. These should be auto-firing. Thankfully these guys only have 2 shields and kinda lousy weapons, really. So we want to distract them out of piloting, which is good. Alright, so now they're busy in here, so you can get back into piloting. And we'll want to turn this on and that on. Now we're going to do this. I guess that's going to have to be good enough. We still need air in here. We can dodge. We just won't. We're done dodging for the time being. You get back in the med bay. You fix this. You also help fix that, and you get it back. Ideally, we won't have to dodge any of this stuff. Now we have the option of turning this back on, and we probably will. Alright, how are the borders doing? They are still in the shields. I will go ahead and let this land and carve them up. Doing 8 damage, 2 damage to their weapons, and a bunch to their other systems. So they're not going to be dodging worth a darn now. They can't hurt us anymore. So that frees our crew up to go deal with the borders. Alright, our doors are broken. I probably should have closed the doors, honestly, but that's okay. Alright, you guys go fix that. And I'm gonna Talbot beat them again. And that should just kill them, straight up. Okay, that was a little bit tricky on the micromanagement aspect, but you can see that our defenses were so great against those awful weapons, I didn't even need to pilot. Most of the time, you can sneak back and forth and just get somebody back into piloting, no issue. And that's certainly a lot easier with the early game ships, where, they don't attack quite so quickly, and they don't have as many borders on your ship. But, they did happen to bomb my oxygen. That won't happen too often, but it can happen. So that got a little bit iffy, but we still recovered pretty nicely out of that, I'd say. So you can see that our weapons are certainly going to cut through ships like butter, and we have gotten very lucky. I thought that was going to get taken over, but seems not. Alright, well that certainly makes my life easier. We still would have been okay. Just means that this isn't even being taken over either. Wow, double lucky. I was expecting to just have to dive through to fleet-controlled beacons, but nope. It seems that it's all in our favor. So what would we be able to buy if we sold the perk anti-personnel drone? We would have 56 scrap. Would that let us buy anything exciting? We could buy a combat 1. That's sort of good, but I don't think I want to spend that much money on it, so I think I won't. And nothing else here is really that exciting. Ion Stunner is kind of a downgrade at this point, and nothing else is good. Burst Laser 2 we wouldn't even want, because you can't fit it into our loadout, and it's not as good as the Halberd beam as far as punchiness is concerned. This is super punchy. So we're not going to sell the anti-personnel drone for sensors. We don't need them. So do I want to fix up? Maybe. Yeah, it's probably prudent. And then I'll buy one more power, and we'll go. Alright, well, we'll call that good. Okay, well, we got pretty lucky here. Oh, well, okay, well, I'm glad I got some fixing done. We certainly could use it. You better fix that fire before the piling gets destroyed, though. Ah, no such luck. Got the bonus damage from the fire. Oh, well, you tried. You definitely tried, though. Can't blame you for trying. Well, we're back down to 14 hull, but, you know, could be worse. Could be down to 10 hull. That'd be much appreciably worse than being down to 14. I think we'll manage somehow. In this case, probably NG-controlled. These are very similar sectors, but NG-controlled is maybe slightly better. Although we have a better chance of running into NG ships that we don't want. Like that one earlier with the defense drone, too. There's slightly more of them here. So, maybe you want to go civilian, then. There's so much free stuff in NG sectors, though. I'm gonna go here anyway. We'll manage. We'll be fine. What's the worst that could happen? We'll make something work. There's another store. We're obviously not going there. We're striking out. We're gonna take names and kick butts, and we're all out of chewing gum. Yes. Give me some more money. There we go. Alright, do I want level 2 oxygen? Probably not. Probably just want more power so we can get some more defenses going. We still don't have the defense drone 1. I'd like that by the end of this sector. We'll see. Okay, there go my engines. Thankfully, they do have a bomb. Hopefully that doesn't do anything important, but if it doesn't, they should be not too bad to deal with at all. These guys are just not well set up at all. It occurs to me I could use my anti-personnel drone to take care of borders, but honestly I'm doing fine with my 3 crew as it is. Obviously now that I'm low on crew, I've got no real reason to sell this anymore. It will help in the final battle, especially if I don't get the mind control. Well, there goes my piling. Not that I really care at this point, but it's worth noting. So you see that even with level 2 doors, they just couldn't do anything. They just didn't get involved with anything before they, you know, had to teleport away. They didn't even beat up my engineer at all. So let's see, what do I want? That's gotta wear off before I can do anything. Let's see, where do we stand? We're still kind of going this way and kind of jumping around in here, I think. Get some of that and then come back, maybe. So, yeah, I probably just want to keep 50 scrap on hand in case I jump next to a store. That's not going to be for a few more jumps, but could come in handy. But I definitely want to have enough money to buy a defense drone 1 if I see one. Because that's just going to make my life so much easier. And the meanwhile, do I want to buy more engines? Maybe. Would help. It helps against every single physical projectile in the game, including drones. So, maybe. Or do I just want to save my money? Could just buy more power. Yeah, I'd say so. That will let us actually power more engines, and we'll save this money till later. So we can jump here, and then probably down. Unless, like, I see a store, we get a lot of money or something, but that's my basic plan. Sure, we'll listen to their problem. So they will most likely die. I mean, there's less than a 50% chance they'll die, but I would prefer if none of my crew died, because I'm down to 3. So I would say we really can't help them. That's too bad. I don't think a Rockman would help. No, a Rockman doesn't help with that option, which is too bad, but, oh well, it was worth a look. Oh, hey, we actually got a fight from this event. That's nice. Okay, what are they hacking first and foremost? Doors. Annoying, but not the worst. So really, as long as we can take that missile out, we're set. So really, this is just a question of whether they hit us in the weapons or not. To that end, I'm gonna rearrange my weapons up, so this is probably the ward I should have them on for the rest of the game, really. I could maybe have fired these a little bit sooner, but I just wanted to make sure that we actually get these shields down so I can get the 2 damage shot in. Because I know that 2 damage would shut this off for sure. Now we should be able to carve them up easily. Get that beautiful, glorious 10 damage to this ship layout. Nope, that is pathetic. I know we're running low on fuel, but 9 fuel is fine for now. We can't afford to not take this surrender. Get some much better money out of it, I'm sure. 41, and 3 fuel anyway. It's all good. Maybe we can run into somebody who wants these missiles. Maybe someday. Probably not today, though. I think we can afford to do this. Because we've got one, probably more beacons till we run into a store. Yeah, I think we're just not going down to this end of the sector at all. I think we're just going to jump around up here till we're all done. Sure. That's some store credit there. That'll sell. And there's a store, so do I want to go there immediately or go to Distress and then the store? I guess I might as well. How many jumps do we have left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5-ish? Do I have time to go to the stress and then the store and still have plenty of time to maybe even get an extra beacon and dive and then go to the exit? So, yeah, I think I'm going to go to stress and then store. Sure. Assistance. 4 damage for 21 scrap. Not great, but acceptable. We, at the very least it pays for my repairs and then some. Nice, but we don't really need any of this stuff, and we don't need any crew, really. I'm not going to spend that much money on a crew at this point. I can tough it out with just 3 crew. So, we're going to sell the Ion Blast for store credit, and we're not going to sell the anti-personnel drone, and I think we're just going to repair. Now, how much more do we want to repair? How many jumps do we have left? 1, 2, 3? Yeah, 3 jumps if we want to just jump straight to the exit. Then we could jump here and jump back if we wanted to. So we could buy a level 6 engine to try that. Or we could just not bother and say I want to spend my money on something else, like, oh, I don't know, level 4 shields. That would certainly help. So, how much more do we want that one beacon, is the thing. It would help. This is Sector 6. It's pretty valuable. I'm going to try it. It'll pay for itself. And that engine will certainly come in handy as well. We're playing things a little bit fast and loose here, because I'm pretty sure we should be okay. Okay, here's an idea. We could use these missiles for something. Or we could just get scrap. So basically the idea is, do we want to give up this beacon's worth of money, and, you know, the missiles, which are basically not important at all, to avoid the fleet fight, and... Or does it avoid the fleet fight? I think it does. So we'll avoid the fleet fight and actually get the money. Like, I think it's just one more beacon then. I think on average we're actually going to do better though. I think we're only going to get one extra beacon out of this if we do this. And there's certainly no guarantee that it's a good beacon. Like, it could be an empty beacon or it could be a beacon where we just get average rewards. I think on average, just the guaranteed money in drone gear is going to be better. That is a pretty good roll. Obviously, the drone isn't that worth that much money, but the cash money value of 44 scrap right now is pretty good. Like, most of the time, you just want to take that money and drone immediately and just go for it. Delaying the fleet could be worthwhile in sectors like this one, if you know you're going to get all 2 of those jumps in, and they're going to be good jumps. So it's probably better if you have long-range scanners and you know that those last 2 jumps are good. But most of the time, I think you just want the money immediately. Money immediately is hard to argue with. In this case, I think we might just want to buy our more power now. Now we have 6 shields and 6 engines, and we can run all this stuff well. Also, we have 2 anti-personnel drones, which is hilarious. I just realized that. And so that'll let us get out of there fairly easily, and then we'll, everything else, probably Shields 4 is next. I mean, we could buy mind control at a store, but that would be fine. Or hacking. Hacking would be great. Alright, the Vulcan. Our ion loadout should be sufficiently powerful and fast enough that that should be an issue. And what's more of an issue is that, that particular missile there. It is an Artemis, but if we hit them in the weapons, we should be in good shape. Don't want to risk it now. It's worth a shot. Might turn off the missile. Nope. Oh yeah, yeah, okay, good. I thought it was worthwhile. They are still not really going anywhere important yet. Now they're going all the way over there. Or for them, I'm not going to mess with weapons loadout, because that's what's going to turn their missile back on. I'm just going to hit their shields harder than some of their other systems and hope that distracts them. Oh well, tell you what though, we can spare one ion particle over there. That might turn off their missile as well. In fact, we might even be able to do this. See if that turns off. Yeah, maybe that heavy ion will turn off their missile. Okay, it did. It did turn off their missile. Dodge. Dodge. There we go. Win that slightly biased coin flip there. And I will go ahead and steal the civilian supplies because this is positive expected value. Gotta love that positive expected value. Even if it makes you feel like a jerk, you still gotta try for that positive expected value. Now what? I don't think we want level 3 piloting or doors or anything like that, so I think we're just going to save up for our level 4 shields or the storm. Yeah, we're going to save up for the storm. Because we could still use an extra system or a defense drone 1 or something. I think we still want to visit one more store before the game's up. So you could exit now and avoid the fleet, but I'm going to dive for this beacon and this beacon, which are both not going to get taken over, and then jump back to the exit. Sure. Alright, we fight pirates. We're not happy to see another pirate with cloaking and missiles. This is why we didn't go to the rock sector, because of fights like this. But we should still mostly be fine. In fact, we have got spare power, so... You know what? Anti-personnel drone, you're on the drone. You're on the case. We need to keep you distracted in here, so you stay in there for the time being. Now you go in there, now the anti-personnel drone will keep you busy. Well, now our pilot can sit here in peace and actually pilot the darn ship. Like so. Alright, and I am going to go ahead and risk this. And there we go. Got that missile off. And their cloaking's offline, too. That's even better. Yeah, they are... Yeah, they're pretty well disabled now. That was, pretty lucky. Man, I just love the halberd beam. It's pretty good. You know what would be even better for this, loadout, though? Would be the glaive beam. We're... fantastically unlikely to actually run into it, and if we see it in a store, we probably won't buy it. But if I get that for free, I am definitely going to try and fit that into this loadout. I would definitely spend 100 scrap to get that money. That would be amazing. Too bad we're probably not going to see it, though. It's probably just not even going to show up now that I said anything about it. Yeah, like I said, gonna save it, see if there's a store in the next sector. If it takes a while, if we're not gonna see a store for a while, then I'll upgrade my shields again, but there's no reason to do anything particular about that right now. Still got one more jump before we have to worry about the, fleet, though. And, oh dear. Okay, you're a bit of a tough customer. Thankfully, he's only got the one ion weapon, though, so... The tricky part is just that he's got these two lasers that are going to be synced up on the first volley. So I'm hoping that they don't sync up that well. This is certainly one time in which I'd like to have been manning my shields. Oh man, you guys are good dodging. Sheesh. Man, I love you guys. You are the best pilot and engineer. Probably, well, I don't want to say that I've ever had, but you're pretty darn good. Alright. So yeah, we're certainly going to try for this. Fit this halberd beam in. Jeez. Alright, well, gonna hold our fire then. Yeah, we're just gonna have to try that again next pull cycle. That's okay. This happens every now and then. And at least now these lasers are desynchronized somewhat. Oxygen's getting a little bit low, though. I'm gonna go ahead and fire this now. I want to make sure I score one damage. I think I just want to focus on getting one of these weapons offline. I don't want to aim it like... I can't aim it like that. No. So, I don't want to maximize damage, and it doesn't really matter if I hit the shield, so I think I just want to do this. Oh, and I got their cloak offline. It was a short cloak. Okay. Well, I shall continue to ionize their shields then. Or at least try to. Was worth a shot, but hey, that temporary damaging their weapon system makes a big difference. Just getting one weapon offline with one damage can really make your life easier sometimes. And I'd say this is certainly one case where that would be true. Yeah, there we go. That's more solid. That's what I like to see. Maybe hit like this? Maybe this is what I want. Yeah, let's try it. Maybe we can get some bonus asteroid hits in, like that. No, we're not going to take that surrender. That is not very good. We're going to get a lot of money for blowing up a big ship like this. This has got to be a really infamous pirate. Alright, let us see. Are they going to get that cloak fixed? No, they won't. Good for us, bad for them. 39, that's not much, but it's okay. Certainly better than nothing. Better than poking the eye with a sharp stick, as my grandmother used to say. I don't think it was my grandmother. It might have been my grandfather. Alright, well, nothing left to do but make it out of here with the goods. Oh. Oh, so we got a wise guy here, huh? Well, we should be out of here before this guy even gets to do anything with those weapons. In fact, if we're lucky, we might even get to stick around and show them what for, but I'll certainly jump out of here if we need to. So here's what I'm hoping. Generally, level 6 engines with a max level engineer and a max level pilot is enough to charge up the FTL before this ASV goes off. The timing on it is slightly random, though. It can either be slightly quicker or slightly sooner, so sometimes, very rarely, this shot will go off too quickly to actually jump out of there with. So what I'm hoping is that... Alright, I think in this case I want to go ahead and just turn one of these off. Just in case we get to stick around. Because if they actually just straight up dodge this, we'll stick around. Alright, we're probably not going to dodge it now. We'll see though. Alright, he is manning the piloting now. So we're gonna wait and see. Okay, it missed. So, that means we have, free license to just stay here and beat these guys up. This other Vulcan is actually fully charged now, or very close to it. But we should be killing them. In fact, we could probably spare an ion shot now. Just to dedicate to turning that thing off. There we go. And now they are completely hopeless. We should be able to carve them up, take their fuel, and get out of here, hopefully. Get us some air here. Get that fuel and now jump out. So we can become even more infamous. Okay, rock controlled or zone controlled? I think we just had this choice earlier. So I think we're doing well enough that we still want to go to Zoltan Control. I'd rather deal with Zoltan Shields than Cloak with a loadout like this. So, I'd say that's a fair choice.